2012 is almost history, but what's the takeaway? Comedian Dean Obeidallah schools us with his top 12 lessons for 2012.
End is nigh. We're about to leave 2012 behind. But before we do, our friend, I don't know about that, comedian, not sure about that either, Dean Obeidallah, that is his name, brings us the 12 lessons of 2012. So we're going to pick out a couple here, but can you tell I'm in a really good mood tonight because of those kids. I am so happy about those kids.
You found children. Who does that? You're not just an anchor. You're a superhero. You're Cory Booker of this world. Cory Booker runs in that house is on fire. You're the equivalent of that. I mean, Bill O'Reilly's never going to do this. Sean Hannity's not going to find children. Don Lemon finds children.
That's pretty awesome. We're having a little fun, and it's good because the kids are found, but it's the power of the medium. And so
absolutely,
it's respectable to have that power. It's amazing. So anyway,
comes with responsibility.
Okay.
Old cliche.
All right, let's talk about the stories. The lessons America's best democracy money can buy. Explain that.
Sure. Well, it's in my article on CNN.com. America is the best democracy money can buy. This presidential election, 2012, broke a record. We spent over $2 billion. Obama, Romney, PACs, super PACs, DNC, RNC. $2 billion. To put this in perspective, that is literally, I'm not exaggerating, literally more than the annual GDP of almost 30 countries in the world we spent on one election cycle. People in Belize and Liberia are shocked by this. There are Americans who could use this money. So right there, $2 billion. And let's be honest, how many individual people are turned off from politics by those kind of numbers?
They feel
powerless.
Some people talk to chairs.
Clint Eastwood, Republican convention, made it okay to talk to your furniture. Since that, I've spoken to my couch on occasion, my end table. I clearly need to have some friends besides coming on TV at 11 o'clock at night on Saturday. But still, I think he made it okay, cool to have fun with your ferns and plants and furniture around the house.
Women love to read porn.
Yes, they do. They love to read porn. I'm talking about 50 Shades of Grey, which we've talked about. It sold over 40 million books, mostly women over 30 who like to read these sexually provocative books. We, of course, men, were waiting for the movie because we're more traditional, and the way we like our porn, we like it visual. Women, internal, they read it and can picture things. I can't picture anything unless I can see it in front of me. What about you, Don? Nothing? You have nothing to say? Like, you leave me out here talking about porn like I'm the weirdo?
I have no idea what you're talking about. I'm going to have to look up what that word means. I have no idea. Yeah, I heard it has something
to
do with
physical. It's porn in quotes, by the way.
That's what I hear.
They call it mommy porn, 50 Shades of Grey. That's what it's called, mommy porn. I'm talking about that kind, not the real weird
stuff. Fiscal cliff. You were talking about it in an article. And as a comedian in the clubs, which you just came from tonight in New York, are people freaked out? So they just, go, whatever, this is crazy, right?
People are so freaked out, they don't even know what the fiscal cliff is. No one is paying attention but us and the media and political people. I'm not kidding you.
Yes, I know.
To them, this is the same old BS they've seen year in and year out now during this hyper-partisan time, and they ignore Congress or hate Congress. That's why it's got a 9% approval rating. Yet we reelected 91% of the people running for reelection last year in Congress. We reelected them because we're liking the person in a bad relationship with low self-esteem. We got to shake ourselves out of this.
Yeah. We live in a vacuum. It's like an echo chamber. Like everyone, I leave here sometimes and I go for friends and have drinks or dinner and I'm like, did you hear about it? And they're like, what? What are you talking about?
Believe me, I brought it up in the clubs the last three nights in a row here in New York. People, like one person knew what the fiscal cliff was. The rest, like, no, they're not paying attention to this. It means nothing to their lives.
Thank you.
Now.
Happy New Year's.
Happy New Year, Don.